album starts with Bridesmaids. And it's a theme that reoccurs in another song later on in the album. It's called The White Crown. And that theme also ends the album. It's about the last things you hear is that music box that ends the same melody, which actually is supposed to, depict the bridesmaids leaving the church together with the bride. And so it starts with that watery sound, because to tell that we're still out there on the ship. I've landed on a desert island because of... this is a very short song, it's only 1 minute and 15 seconds long, but it goes into a song called The Quartermaster. It's a fantastic song, how it came about, because I was on these music forums back in 2005, and this guy, Martin Skog, which means Martin Forest in Swedish, 17-year-old boy who sent me just for fun, 8 bars of, actually the chorus, the rhythm section, the guitar and the bass line and the drums, just that bit. He sent that to me. He didn't have anything else than that. And I just heard, I'll just put this organ or mellotron chords over it, and a da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da just came about then. This was in 2005. And I just shelved it, and I thought, I actually forgot about it. And I was just looking through my vaults, and I was listening back to, hey, wait a minute, this is a great track. Maybe I should write a song around this bit. And so I did. And that didn't take too long. It all came naturally to me. So The Quartermaster is also, that's the new character on the album, the lyric is actually, he was a royal blood by a harlot mother, a prostitute, and felt a bit rejected and joined the vampire's team and went out on the sea with a vampire and self-proclaimed quartermaster, I'll take you to a desert island. I'm not really sure what happened to him, if they left him there and just, continue the journey, because it's still a journey going. Moving on to the next track. Okay. This guy, Anders Wahlbeck, has been working with Tarja from, she was in this band Nightwish. He's a very established songwriter. Also Swede, and lives in Stockholm. Had an idea of a song, he approached me through Facebook actually and said, I wonder if you have any ideas what to do with this piece of music. And I've heard about his name, I've heard of him before, so I knew he was a serious guy. We ended up writing that song together that actually didn't go on the album because we had more stuff, we started to do more stuff, and we thought, it was just a bit too sweet, that song, a bit too cheesy. I wanted more attitude. So we had some more songs, and that ended up being one of them, When the Music Dies. He had basically the drum loop, which then Don Perry added his own real drums blended in, so we have actually it's a drum loop and him playing along with the drum loop, and we're mixing it in, and this Don's fills, I believe. And then Tony Levin added a distorted, like a fuzz Chapman stick over it, and it was also Anders's basically keyboard arrangements. I added guitar, and all the backing vocals is me as well as the lead. And I wrote the lyrics together. He was in New York. I couldn't come up with a good idea. We wrote them together. He came up with the idea, and I elaborated on the lyrics. And I think this was just when, who was one of the last ones to pass away? Was it George Michael last year? I mean, they all went, Prince, George Michael, Keith Emerson, the list is very long. I know I'm forgetting one of the greats now. Anyhow. I just felt that if I just tweak the lyrics just a little bit, it actually is a tribute to all the greats we lost last year when the music dies. And also the lyrics made much more sense. Of Bowie, of course. There you go. He was the one who started it. Okay, I'm going. The other ones felt like, okay, if you're going, I'm fucking going too, man. That's how it feels. So that's when the music dies. And then we come to the White Crown, and the White Crown is again the bridesmaid's melody. That it has again the same sound image as the quartermaster. It's got the harpsichord, you know, flamboyant, very flamboyant, over the top kind of a song. Incorporates baroque music, heavy metal, funk, soul. Almost like Broadway musical bits. It's over the top, the song, and I completely go mad for it because it's a little bit like how Queen would do it when they would just mix things up and it becomes very flamboyant, just like my stage persona is. You know? So that is the White Crown. I did that in 2 days, I remember. I went to bed at 5 a.m. and said, oh, just gonna do this bit too. Oh, I just hear the sound of string here. I need to add that too. And I was looking for sounds and I just couldn't get myself to bed in time, you know. And finally I had the song and I think I just wrote the lyrics the day after and recorded it, and that was it. And then I had the guys recording the bits over there, Jonas Reingold on bass and Nick DiVigilio on drums. And Jonas even tracked the riff. There's a guitar riff in there. I'm a decent guitar player, but Jonas, you know, he had his own touch to his sound much better than mine. But I do all the other guitars on that. And the synths and what have you. Fun track.